What was I saying?
I have no clue. Though you were talking about grassroots movement, and then yeah.
Oh, these you know, just a young ragtag group of kids, hippies, musicians. But they became very interested in social issues. So, you know, you've got at Woodstock, you know, you've got country Joe McDonald or whatever singing, pick up your gun, we're going to have a whole lot of fun. It's 1, 2, 3, what are we fighting for? Don't ask me, I don't give a damn. Mm-hmm. The next stop is Vietnam. And saying such caustic things. You can be the first one on your block to have your son brought home in a box. They were just in your face with their attitude about what the government had done, getting us embroiled in a war that we never should have been in the first place, or at a minimum, we should have at least gave the armament support and backup to get the war won, not put them there and then start cutting off their funding and making a big political issue. This is what politicians always do, and it always burns me that we put soldiers in harm's way and then we start, you know, doing the political two-step, testing the air. And of course, we've had generals on the battlefield that have mm-hmm. come in conflict with our own presidents over issues like this yep. and drew a line in the sand. Well, in any case, I've been waiting. Mm-hmm. I've been waiting and waiting year after year after year, and there is something now mm-hmm. that is happening, and I love it. I don't know. I don't even really know where it's going, but I love the attitude behind it. And what I would tell every young person out there that's listening to this, not to listen to their government right now. When they start trying to stereotype you as being unpatriotic mm-hmm. because you're willing to stand up and challenge the status quo from the establishment or from the government, that is baloney. Patriotism is exactly what they're doing. Patriotism is standing up in defense. When we broke away from a dictatorship known as Great Britain and came here, that's what we fought and died for. Our liberty, our freedom, the right to say what I want to say. Obviously, restrictions. You don't run into a giant building screaming fire, fire, where somebody's going to get hurt. But I love what's happening, Alex, and it's your generation. To me, it is the coolest thing I have seen in a very long time. I'm glad that people are finally waking up, and they're not going to take it anymore. Well, that's a very good thing.
This is a very unique time to be alive. Instead of looking back at the past, wishing that it was late 60s again, which some people do, I don't believe that in this car of life, in this journey of life that we're on, that we could spend our lives looking in the rearview mirror. We can only go forward. And as we talked about earlier with the potential future, it's like being in a semi going 90 miles an hour and there's a cliff ahead, and unless we turn that wheel and go either left or right, we're not going to avert crashing over the cliff. And so that's definitely how it feels right now. This is actually much more critical than the late 60s.
And thankfully, you have many more tools. You know, in the 60s, not even very many people had a television. Look at what we have now. We've got Twitter, Facebook,
YouTube,
the internet.
That's right.
You're here doing a television show. So your generation has a phenomenal opportunity now.
It feels
now
like a blessing, to be
changes.
Honest with
it
you.
It is a blessing.
What I have and the ability to even do this show here with you know, not a lot of money, it feels like a blessing.
It is a blessing, and I'm glad you're doing it, and I'm glad that actually you've been out there for years ahead of a lot of people your age. You've been a groundbreaker. You've been a way paver, and thankfully you have, and now a lot of others are following you, and I'm glad they are.
Thank you. Well, Tom, thank you very much for coming on.
Hey, Alex.
What can we expect from you in the future? Future speaking engagements, websites that you'd like to promote, things you've got coming up?
Well, people can continue to go to Raiders News Network every day. And if they keep coming back, they'll realize we're not really as radical as we first appear to be. And frankly, they may learn something about the future of technology, transhumanism, where we're going. We're working on another book right now. We're working on a new national conference. Mm. Actually, just chaired a meeting in which we got the movers and shakers to agree with us. It's going to be happening out of Branson, Missouri. Be a lot more information forthcoming about that in 2011. Also, there's a new artist movement called Artist Expressway, and they can go to YouTube right now and type in Tea Party National Anthem or something like that, or go to artistsexpressway.com and see one of the first YouTubes up there called Freedom. And here again, it's artists who are taking the very issues that you're talking about, but they're not talented to do television. Their talent is singing or playing an instrument. And even the artist community is starting to wake up and saying, this is the talent we have, and we can use this to make a very social, positive piece of commentary right now. And the whole song Freedom is, you're not going to shut me up, you're not going to back me down, and you're not going to take away the future of my child.
Well, it's not just about this new renaissance. I think we're going into doing it one way. Humanity's too unique for that. there's a number of different ways we can express our creativity and imagination, and I think that's exactly what we're doing. So I'd like to thank you again for coming on. Have a good, safe trip back. For those that will want to learn more about Tom Horn, Google him, and YouTube and Google, and on the internet, you'll find a lot of information as well. Also, check out his new book, Apollyon 2012. Also, very interesting stuff. Until next week, I'm Alex Hanser, reminding you that the path to the ultimate truth still starts at one place, and that's within. Stay safe. Good night.